Hi, I'm Dr. Peggy Whitson. I currently work at the Johnson Space Center and I'm an astronaut. Was born and raised in South Central Iowa on a farm near Beaconsfield, Iowa, and went to a high school in Mount Air, Iowa. And hard to believe Iowa farm girl could be talking to mission control centers around the world. When I was 9 years old, I watched Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin walk on the moon.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Of course, everybody, when you're nine, has lots of different ideas about what you want to be when you grow up. And when I graduated from high school, that was the year they selected their first female astronauts. And that's, I think, when it became a goal for me as opposed to just a dream. I wanted to try and attain this goal, and that was to be an astronaut. I flew on the International Space Station on 2 6-month tours. It was a great time. We did a lot of different scientific research as well as the construction of the International Space Station itself. Each element, for instance, the modules that we have the scientific laboratories in are the size of a large school bus with the truss, for instance, that holds the solar arrays that generate all the power for the International Space Station are actually the length of a football field long, and the solar array elements themselves are 239 feet. So it's a huge structure that we built in orbit. But I'm passionate about space.
Space. The final frontier.
What we do in space is important from a philosophical level for what we provide back to the Earth and the planet, for pushing on ourselves to do things that, you know, we didn't think were possible. I think that's really important. It's one of NASA's goals to go out there and try and inspire young people to be in these fields. We need these new scientists and engineers to take us on the next step, the next phase of exploration. One of the most exciting things was looking at suspension, a colloidal suspension of iron that using electromagnetic fields we could make into solid structures. And this has future benefits in shock absorbers and suspension bridges and technology development that way. But what was really neat was on board the space station, I accidentally, instead of putting in 20 hertz on the electromagnetic field, I put in 2, and they got some results that they had not seen or expected to see on the ground. And so, much like research on the ground, the most interesting things are, I wonder why that happened. For fun on board the International Space Station, probably the coolest thing to do is look out the window and see how beautiful the Earth is, see if you can capture some of that beauty to share with the folks on the ground. I think for me it was a determination. I applied to be an astronaut for 10 years and I just kept pursuing that. And it's, I think, really important for young people out there, no matter what your goal is, whether it's to be an astronaut or to be an artist or to be a scientist or an engineer, whatever that goal is, the important thing is you're going to have to work to attain it. And so that's really important, that perseverance and dedication to stick with it and make it happen, because you can live your dreams.
Rockwell Collins, building trust every day, supporting education for a brighter future.